if the patient cannot do what he needs to do or wants to do because of either pain or weakness, once he has tried that non-surgical treatments that we talked about, that is the therapy, the injections, the medication, the braces, if all that were to fail, and it'll fail in about 1 out of 20 patients, that's when I would talk to the patients about the advantages as well as the risks of spinal surgery.